Hello and good day, everybody. I hope you're doing fine. We're having some excellent weather today, over 22 degrees centigrade. It's sunny and really nice. And I'm gonna try to do some work on the rear brakes, the hose and the pipe on the rear brake. It's rusted so hard onto the lower connector, to the hose out to the caliper, that I have to remove the section going further up into the brake system. If you're new to the channel, this is my 2000 Range Rover P38. It's a green metallic, 2.5 turbo diesel automatic, and I'm doing some work on it, getting it ready and inspected to get them back on the road. And for those already familiar with this channel, thanks for watching. I really appreciate you guys' support and feedback. It's really awesome to see that I can help somebody else fix their other Range Rovers as well. Watching my previous video, I noticed that the audio on this other camera is really terrible. So I'm gonna try and record this audio on my phone instead. And I'm gonna look for a separate audio recording device. Something perhaps with our wireless microphone. So until I get that, I might do some dubbing and voiceover and record some audio with the phone and see how that goes. Here you can see I had a problem disconnecting the brake pipe from the hose that goes down to the caliper. I replaced this hose with a brand new hose. When I tried to take off the pipe, I twisted off the connector and pipe because it was so rusted. So I tried to make a new flange on the old pipe, and but it was still leaking brake fluid. So now I'm going to replace this hose that goes up to another connection just above the frame, this connection here, and then also replace that flexible hose going up there and connecting to a new brake pipe here. I managed to get this connection off on this brake pipe and the hose. I'll just replace the whole section going down there now. Using an 11 millimeter spanner, I'm loosening up this brake pipe going into this flexible hose. And I'm of course placing a catch pen to catch the brake fluid that comes out when we disconnect the pipe. Using a wire brush, I'm removing any rust and debris from the connection so that we don't get that into the new hose and pipe going down to the caliper. Here I'm disconnecting the pipe from the flexible hose and moving it out of the way a little bit. You can see the brake fluid flowing out. The flexible hose is held in place with a clip, so just use a big flat screwdriver and remove it. This is what the clip looks like. Then just push out the brake hose. This is rusted to the bracket a little bit, so I'm just forcing it out a little bit with a screwdriver. Here you can see the flexible hose a little bit better. Now you just need to do the same thing on the other side of the hose. Remove that clip that's holding it in place. Just slide the clip out using a big flat screwdriver again. And now I'm just taking the hose out of the bracket again. And then I'm using an 11 millimeter to loosen up this pipe going into the lower hose, going to the caliper. Once I have the pipe loose, I'll try and maneuver it out through the bracket hole on the top with the flexible hose attached. And here you can see me trying to maneuver the pipe and hose out through the top. And here's the hose, and that's the connection that's rusted so hard that I couldn't get it off. And that means I have to replace the whole section with a hose, pipe and hose. And here I have the two hoses I bought from Germany. This is steel. And this is copper, and you want to use the copper one. So I'll get a new hose attached to this end, and then we'll try and put it back in. Here I'm trying to maneuver the new hose back in place. Make sure that notch on the top, the flat end, fits with the hose so that the hose doesn't twist around in the bracket. Attach a clip. I'm using a new one because the old one was really rusted and nasty. And then we'll do the same thing on the other end of the hose. Make sure that the notch attaches to the bracket so that the hose stays in place, and attach the clip again on that side too.
You'll want to leave the caps on the end of the hose in place until you're ready to attach the brake lines. Then we are ready to attach the brake line. We'll attach it by hand and then screw it in with a spanner. Now I'm ready to feed up the new brake pipe and attach it by hand to the lower end of the brake hose. Again, this is easier if you can lay on the back under the car or if you have a car on a lift and can access and see what you're doing. Once that's done, we're ready to bend the pipe carefully and smoothly into place so that we get the connected to the lower end of the brake hose going to the caliper. We'll attach the brake pipe by hand first and then we'll tighten the nut snugly to the brake hose going to the caliper. Then we'll clean off everything and make sure it's nice and then attach the ABS sensor connector to the clip under the bracket and make sure the cables aren't kinked or gonna catch on anything. So for on the right side, I have this brand new airbag going in. This is the bottom and this is the top. You remove that one and insert the new the air hose into it. And there's one clip on the bottom and one clip on the top. And I got brand new clips and it's supposed to go in like that and around the airbag like that. A bit hard to see, but there's the clip in and there's the connection for the air hose. So I just remove this temporary shader valve and clean off the pipe a little bit and then we'll insert it. There we go. Then we just need to attach the lower part of it. And then we need to jack up the axle a little bit. That's the way the clip goes in under here and into the bottom of the airbag. So there we go, one brake fixed and one airbag done. I still have my left front one to do, but I'll do that tomorrow. So that's what I got for today. We got the brake fixed, hopefully, and the airbag replaced. If you find this useful and interesting, consider subscribing. Comment below, hit that like button if you like this video. And as always, thanks for watching and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Here's my black Range Rover, and in case you were wondering why I haven't put out a video yesterday, I was busy trying to level out this area with fine gravel for the concrete, and I also extended my parking lot a little bit so that I have more space.